Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. We're up to episode 4 of our Illusionist Let's Play. We're playing Conquest of Elysium. So we have two opponents left. We have the dwarves up here, and we have the Scourge Lord to our west. The Scourge Lord is by far the strongest opponent, so we just have a quick look at the score graphs. So this is the army graph, and green is the Scourge Lord, we're the red, and as you can see, yeah, Scourge Lord is pretty much running away with it at the moment. Have a look at citadels held. We actually own the most cities, major cities, so these are places where you can recruit from, and we have pretty decent gold income, although we have lost a little bit of territory recently. Then we have iron income, and the dwarves are pretty good at that. We don't need a lot of iron income as the illusionist, but a little bit is good. And then all the rest are sort of resources that are more unique to certain factions, so it doesn't make a lot of sense to compare those. Alright, so we have army here is basically. Press the wrong button there, I don't want to move it there. Okay, so we have an army here which is basically just keeping the dwarven settlement here in check, so it keeps sending. Very small armies, it has to be said. You sort of, like we see here, just individual commander really. Sometimes there might be sort of 10 to 15 units. So we just have this little force here. We've got a white wizard and our illusionist and three mirrors. So yeah, so that's more than enough. Keep killing these commanders. Can't take the city, it's just too well defended. I can't spare the force like sending this up there to do it. Because we've got to deal with the Scourge Lord as well. And the Scourge Lord keeps stealing our locations. Alright, so this is one of his armies. We have. Did we see another one last turn? I can't remember. I think there might be another one similar size. I'm sure we saw that in the last few turns. We have a lot of mirrors. Just having a look. Alright, so one is empty. So these mirrors have charges, as we found out. So this has got three charges left. Basically three battles, as far as I can tell. Alright, that's empty. Okay, well, if we wanted to attack that, we could only replenish one mirror this turn. So that spell costs us 10 gems, and yeah. The thing we've been doing is we summoned a couple of phase beasts, which cost 25 gems. We've got these two guys here. I haven't really tried them in combat yet, so they've got lots of attacks. And they're fast. And this sort of displacement, sort of an illusionary effect, I guess, that you know gives them a bit of protection, especially against ranged attacks. So. I have two minds where to go for them. I think because we've got mirrors that still need replacement, we've got to recharge those. And then if they attack as well, so be it. Alright, so I've got a very small army here, which was. It's just sort of retaking territory that monsters had taken off us. So apart from monsters spawning, so we've got this serpent guarding the pit, which we assume is an entrance maybe to either the underworld, i.e. Hades, or the normal underground realm where the pale ones stop. Could be. I'm not sure we will find out in this playthrough, because this guy is a little bit too strong to take on with the forces we've got here. So why don't we bring these west? We've got a watchtower there and a lookout there that we don't own. In fact, actually, we've got a very lightly defended port up there, so they can head in that direction. Okay, we've got Kraken. So Krakens are amphibious, they can come on both land and sea. And then we've got an apprentice down here. And we've got we just hired this guy, didn't we? Metal Arcane there. So we're just going to put him, actually. Look at our forces. Let's hire So we've just got an individual captain here, and he's going to die fairly soon, I would imagine. We've just discovered the Imperial Capital, which the Scourge Lord has. Well, he's overrun the top half of it, sure. Looks like he's probably overrun it all. And that'll do.
Crossbow and a mace.
do. That is not. Alright, so this was. We suffered a lot. All our mirrors survived, by the looks of it, but we lost our leader. Stuck there. So that's pretty bad. Okay. Let's recruit some swordsmen. So we've lost our best leader, which is pretty bad in the scheme of things. I'll just leave you there. I like how this guy's surviving, stealing all these little settlements. So there you see the Dwarven city with their leader, Devala. So she, I think she auto spawns, yeah, dwarves. Which is why every now and then we get little incursions coming down. And if it wasn't for all these ballista, to assault it, but with blister and a whole bunch of these arbalasts, which do 1 to 10 damage, we wouldn't stand a chance. Okay, we are going to enter. Good, we've got another apprentice. Apprentice down here. And what was that? We got offered a sorceress, which we can't afford. Silver Arcana. Okay, I haven't seen that one before. There seem to be dozens of different magic type mages. So this illusionist hasn't really got any decent spells at the moment. Yeah, nor is this one, because this 5 gem with a mirror is pretty useless. Just binds sort of level 1 spell into the mirror. Whereas we want the 10 gem spell. Now we can obviously perform this lesser ritual, which gives a new level 1 spell. So when we need to repopulate mirrors, that's what we will have to do. Thank you. think we're going to split off one of these. Why don't we split off the mage, a few crossbowmen, and a few infantry. They took a dive in that battle. They lost more than us, but the building goes pretty low. It's always been low though. I don't think they really use gold that much. So they build these pillars, like we see here, pillar of power. And that sucks life force from the land around and turns it slowly into desert. So we can see this has become savanna around here. And I think if it left it long enough, it would become desert, like down here. And I'm guessing, I've never actually played the Scourge Lord, so I don't know for sure, but I'm guessing that then that gives one, you know, a resource which they use then to summon their units. Alright, we will end the turn. Forgot to go and kill those. Okay, that's not good. These tech, they just stop them spawning armies. Okay. Good job, I suppose, that we split these guys off. Okay, they've got no armor, which is good. He's got 3 armor. The problem is, if he gets armies escape through here, then they go wandering off, and it's just such a pain chasing them down. There's only an archer in there. else? We have feeble-minded. That really only affects spellcasters. Or if he comes up against magic. He's got two magic resistance, so yeah, he's not going to resist any magic. Let's see if we can take that. You can stay there. So that was, yeah, this lets us teleport the army. So I'm going to give that to the apprentice. Should probably be on one of our frontline fighters. Yep, that'll do. I don't know what we're facing here, but they've generally been we had quite a while where sort of we were inflicted with undead around here, and do we have some face spiders or something like that? So I'm a bit wary that it might be the same over here. In which case, sort of 10 normal units and a captain isn't going to win. Before we venture out. I think that was where we saw their army, wasn't it? just continue alternating between swordsman and crossbowman. We're up to 84 income. That's pretty good. Gems are recovering as well. Why don't we select this guy and start leveling him up? Scrying is pretty useless. Two units. It's probably going to be more than we can cope with these two armies. What we can see, I mean, their power base is obviously the Imperial Capital. We don't know how far that extends. Don't know how far that extends either. But one would sort of imagine in not very far. That might go west quite a way, it's hard to tell. Buy that wand. That'd be quite good to give to our Illusionist, because they don't really tend to have. Well, this guy's actually got a few battle spells. What we've had before have really only had sort of crowd control spells. And I was just thinking this wand might be pretty good to give him something to do long range in battle, and it is pretty good, 1 to 20 damage. Whoever took this is obviously a stealthy unit. If we get off with a scout, we should probably buy it. We got decimated by the wizard in there, so I'm not going to send it over there. I'm really wary of hidden units. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna just drop off an infantry here. And then we're gonna come back. When they attack that, we'll find out what we're actually facing. Yeah, we're not going to have much of a chance, I feel, against this lot. Ooh, what's this? Scourge Flame. Got a pretty nasty attack. It's only for close range. But yeah, lots of spiders and ants, and the Scourge King. Okay, so that's the leader by the looks of it. Greater spell. Yeah, that doesn't really entice me. It's fairly cheap though. Maybe having one or two mirrors that can cast these sort of terror sort of crowd control spells might be worth it. So that was a silver mirror. So if 30 gold. Go on, we'll cast one of those. Nothing happening there. Okay, we said we're gonna stay there. Okay. Okay. Let's have a look at these statues. So they can cast spells. Life force spellcasting range 4. Okay, so they're going to drain health by the looks of it. In the range of 4. That's the one I want to take because that's a citadel. I can recruit from there. This one is only going to give us 2 gold, so we're going to leave that. Just have another look at these statues. Yeah, it doesn't seem to have anything else going for it. It's just this spellcasting level one and this drain life. Which we need to see in action really to know how deadly that's going to be. Tells us exactly what it's going to cast. Yeah, colour spray. That's pretty good. That's an offensive spell. There's maybe some more of those mirrors. Wouldn't be too bad after all. How many charges has it got? Is it 20 charges? Yeah. It's only slowing combat, which is good. Okay, let's buy another silver mirror. Populate it. Pretty good against human type opponents. Thank you. Illusionist statue casts Tendril of Darkness. Magic resistance negates. Yeah, I'm not really seeing two resistance to damage. Yeah, it's got only three. Here we're just going to carry on building up a force. And wait and see if they push any forces down here, then we, at that point we'll respond with it. And in the meantime, just try and tie them up over here as much as we can. So they still haven't attacked us there. Why don't we range back here? Do the same thing, drop off one unit. Okay, so wandering creatures have gone in there. I'm quite happy to let them own that rather than the Scourge Lord. Could liberate that. Let's carry on to the mirrors. Spells in them. I've sort of changed my opinion a little bit on these because they are so cheap. Okay, that's another one with terror. Probably do want to hire some with that we can put phantasms in. So I would like the higher version, so I don't really want to too quickly, so let's... Not sure, mirror walk? I haven't come across that one before. Illusionist steps into an empty mirror and reappears in another empty mirror anywhere in the world. Okay. Yeah, that only applies to the Illusionist himself though, not to his army. It makes it a little bit less useful. But yeah, it's still interesting. We want to transfer him quickly, say, from that city there to the Imperial capital. That'd be one way of doing it. We've got a decent number of infantry now, so why don't we get more crossbowmen? You stay where you are and carry on. So you can sort of see the graphical difference, you know, these are populated, sort of got that sort of cracked mirror look to them, whereas these are vacant. Catapults I find pretty useless. They seem to just have six shots and that's it. Never do anything else the rest of the battle. Let's get the archers. We're going to make a stand here. Sort of, in a way, hope he attacks us. We're just going to populate our mirror. If if he attacks us and we win, I sort of feel we probably effectively won the campaign at that point. If he wipes us out, that'd be a different story. I don't remember seeing a battle. Suggest then they just get an overrun against our unit and all our efforts to find out what is attacking us goes to waste. Alright. Well, we're going to recruit some more units before we head back. And the turn, he didn't attack us. Damn! Buy the better mirrors here. I'm still not going to attack him behind the fortifications. Why don't we wait a turn though, because if he's going to attack us next turn. Probably don't want more range. We want more foot soldiers. Thank you. daring to go for us, is he? Which is both good and bad. One is obviously doesn't think he can beat us, and the bad is it makes it harder for us to wipe him out. Alright, well, let's end this episode here, and we'll find out what happens in the next one. So, thanks for watching. Hopefully you're enjoying it, and I'll see you in the next episode.